I'm Micah Smith, and this is Tech Talks. In this Tech Talk, we're going to try to understand what AARI is and how AARI can be used to accelerate your digital transformation initiatives. We'll be looking at how we can use these digital assistants to integrate with our bot runs so that we can automate tasks within our daily work. So first off, what is AARI? AARI is the Automation Anywhere Robotic Interface, AARI. That's what that stands for. And so AARI enables federated engagement through robotic process automation initiatives. That sounds super complex, but really what it's doing is it's allowing humans and bots to work together more closely. And I love this concept, right? Before, bots were only really run through, you know, scheduling or through watching a file directory and eventually a file shows up and the bot runs, or even sending an email, right? That was really as personal as it got. But with AARI, we have the ability to run bots through lots of different ways. So we can do it through native application plugins, right? If I'm already in Excel, I can run an AARI bot directly from Excel and pass it values and wait for values to come back. I can use it with interactive desktop forms. So if there's processes that I need to run on my own machine, right, like an attended automation situation, I can have AARI run in that case. It can show me a form. I can fill out some data, right? Maybe it's specific to my workstation or my use case. And so my other coworkers use the same bots, but we use these forms that allow us to differentiate what AARI is actually going to do on our workstation. That's another great use case for AARI. And the third component there is a collaborative web interface. And so it allows for lots of different individuals to send tasks to bots and then also to complement the tasks that the bots are already doing. So the bot runs, it goes and fetches a bunch of data. Maybe the bot's not sure about certain data or the data needs to be validated. A human can get involved to actually validate and perfect the results of what the bot has done. And even that could trigger another bot, right, to go generate a report or to send some kind of email, right? So that web interface allows users to actually interact with and engage with the bots in a totally new way. Let's take a look at what this actually means for AARI. So there's really three components here, right? The first is AARI for apps, and we kind of talked about that already. AARI for apps are plugins that allow me to interface with bots through Excel, through Google Sheets, or through Salesforce. And so I don't have to leave the application I'm already working in. I can invoke AARI bots, or I can invoke bots directly from those interfaces. This executes on unattended bots. So that means that, you know, I'm in Excel, I need the bot to go do something based on the data that I have in my Excel spreadsheet. The bot will go off and run. That bot run will actually take place on a server someplace, right? So it's not gonna affect my local workstation. I can keep working, I can keep doing whatever I need to do, and that data will come back and allow me to update my spreadsheet. For AARI for desktop, right? For AARI for desktop, those are processes that actually need to run locally on my own machine, right? And may need the use of forms. So I need this one bot to run locally. It's going to do three or four things for me. I fill out this form that, you know, gives the bots some specific parameters of exactly what needs to be done or what inputs it might need. The bot will run. In that case, it's running on my local workstation. So I'm going to have the bot run. I'm going to have it automate stuff on my direct workstation. It's not going to be running on a server someplace. It's running locally. And then finally, AARI for web, and that was that web interface that we talked about that allows for that collaborative interface where more than one user or more than one human can interact with that bot. We can have the bot, you know, reassign tasks to other people. I might kick off a bot and then it goes to one of my coworkers or it goes to my manager for approval based on the dollar value of some transaction, right? So there's lots of different ways that you can kind of work that around. But again, this is going to be for unattended bot runs. So this is where, you know, I'm going to kick off a task. The bot is going to execute on a bot runner, which is usually like a virtual machine running on a server or running in the cloud. And that's going to run and give data back to me through the AARI web interface. So again, I can kick that bot off. I can go back to doing whatever I was doing. Maybe that's starting multiple bot runs, or maybe that's working on something totally different. And then I can come back to that web interface to see the results of the bot run, right? Maybe the bot did a bunch of research. It came back to me with those answers. It's waiting for my approval. I can give that approval. I can kick off another bot, or the bot can end there and send me an email, however the bot is configured. But again, when you think of AARI, you want to think about a digital assistant that's allowing me to engage with bots in a totally new way. This has been Tech Talks. I'm Micah Smith. Go be great.